That's the first lesson we learn. The second incident that I want to do doesn't have an immediate moral, but we will get back to the morals of it. The second incident involving Mutim ibn Adi is the boycott. You all know the boycott of the Prophet ﷺ when he was boycotted and he lived for 2 years in the valleys and he was outside of Mecca. That the Prophet ﷺ and the Muslims were boycotted. Now, how was the boycott broken? Some of the Quraysh felt that this was going too far. And so they gathered together, the two, three of them who were sympathetic to, not to the Muslims, but sympathetic to justice. Some Quraysh, some idol worshippers said, you know, how can we treat our relatives in this manner? They're our cousins, they're our brothers, they're our tribe. How can we let them starve to death? How can we deprive them from water? This is inhumane. None of them were Muslims. These are all pagans. And one of them was Mut'im ibn Adi. Mut'im ibn Adi was one of those who said, for how long are we going to allow our own kinsmen to live in this dismal fashion? So what did he do? He and a group of the other Quraysh, there was four or five of them, they said, you know what? We will break the contract. We will break the boycott. We're going to demolish the boycott. How did they do that? They set up a really interesting, if you like, way of doing it. And that is that one time when all of the Quraysh were gathered together in their parliament, if you like, in front of the Kaaba, one of them stood up and he said, for how long are we going to starve our own relatives to death? These are our own cousins, our own kith and kin. I, for one, say we need to break this boycott. Before Abu Jahl, before Abu Lahab, before any of them could say anything, Mut'im stood up and he said, you know, I totally agree. This boycott is completely unjust. I never agreed to it in the first place. And then a third person stood up. And then all of these are planted, right? All of these are planted people. That three, four, five people stood up and Abu Jahl started to shout and Abu Lahab and others. But the four or five who stood up, they continued shouting and Mut'im was one of them until finally Abu Jahl said, this is a plot you guys agreed to do. I figured this out. This is a plot you guys agreed to do, but the plot won. They won in this plot and the boycott was effectively broken. What does this show us? It shows us that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sometimes uses people who are idol worshippers, non-Muslims, but who believe in justice, who believe in truth. He uses them to bring back that truth and justice. And Mut'im ibn Adi is one of those people. Jubayd is the name of his son, by the way. Jubayd accepted Islam. Mut'im never accepted Islam till he died. Jubayd ibn Mut'im is one of the noble companions. His father, Mut'im ibn Adi, never accepted Islam. And by the way, one of the other things Mut'im did, check this out. You're not going to believe the generosity of this man. He's a non-Muslim. He's an idol worshiper. Till he died, he worshipped an idol. Yet when he heard that the Quraysh boycotted the Banu Hashim, and he was a Qurashi, he lived in Makkah, you know what he would do? He would purchase a camel with his own money. And he would load the camel with grain and with well, they didn't have rice, but with wheat, with all of this barley and dates and water. And he would take it in the middle of the night to the valley where the Muslims were basically camped. And he would hit the camel on the back so the camel would go forward and they would find the camel. This camel would give them meat for months. They would dry the meat. It would give them dates. It would give them food. And were it not for Allah and then this type of regular generosity, the Muslims would have starved to death. Mut'im was the main supporter of providing food and he did it surreptitiously. He did it illegally. The Quraysh had banned their fellow Qurayshites from giving food to the Muslims, right? But Mut'im was one of those who said, I don't care what the law says. This is an unjust, illegal law. And so he was of those who would donate of his time and literally his money. And he would send, this is a lot of money to give a camel. That's literally like what a car would cost in our times. You know, $15,000 is basically, that's what a camel would cost, our equivalent. And he would ladle it with food and water and send it in. This is Mut'im ibn Adi. And this shows us, brothers and sisters, that subhanAllah, Allah has blessed people with good hearts, even if they are not Muslims. Listen to me carefully. I know some of you are like, they don't understand this point, but believe me, this is the whole point, brothers and sisters. Just because you're not a Muslim doesn't mean you have no good in you. Just because you don't believe in Allah and you are worshiping another God, that's wrong. That's kufr. I'm not justifying it. But just because you're of another faith, you might still have a lot of good in other areas and avenues. And our religion says that those people who stand for truth and justice, we stand with them. Those people who are fighting against injustice, fighting oppression, fighting racism. There are many in this land here in America. They are fighting against these racist, oppressive laws like the Patriot Act. There are many who are speaking out against foreign policy of our own land. These are people, they might be atheists. Many of them are atheists. They're agnostics. But they have good in them. They have good in them. You can quote me on this, brothers and sisters. They have good. They don't have the ultimate good. The ultimate good is the worship of Allah. Correct.